Say if we found life on Mars and it had a similar genetic structure as life on Earth, does that mean we've discovered aliens? Sadly not. It's more likely a sign of a dirty, dirty robot. Hello, I'm Ian O'Neill, space producer for Discovery News, and I wanted to take a few minutes to talk about Martians. Unfortunately, these Martians may not be from Mars at all. Confused? Well, if you've ever seen those signs in public toilets urging you to wash your hands to avoid the spread of germs and viruses, you probably already have a fairly good grasp of planetary protection and why spreading bacteria far and wide can be a bad thing. And this rationale goes for Mars, where we recently discovered short-lived flows of liquid water. This discovery wasn't just another Mars water discovery. We already knew water exists in the ground, in the atmosphere, and in the poles in the form of ice and vapor. But this was an amazing finding that liquid water exists on the surface of Mars. On Earth, where there's water, there's life. So when NASA made this discovery, astrobiologists got really excited. Although it would be totally unadvisable to drink this water from the source because it contains highly toxic salts, there's the possibility that some kind of basic Mars life may be using this water as an oasis. To test this hypothesis, scientists would love to send a Mars rover to the slopes where these water flows have been found. But there's a problem. Although NASA goes through great pains to sanitize their hardware before it leaves Earth to land on Mars, some hardy Earth bacteria are known to be particularly adept at surviving in extreme conditions, surviving decontamination procedures. Also, as cleaning solar panels, circuit boards, gears, bolts, and cables costs a lot of money, NASA's cut back on some decontamination measures to save cash, and we're talking hundreds of millions of dollars. Interestingly, the cleanest Mars surface mission was actually the Viking landers that explored the Red Planet in the 1970s. These first missions were designed specifically to seek out life, so NASA spared no expense making sure they were crazy clean. Now that NASA's Mars program is more focused on seeking out habitable environments rather than specifically searching for life, have terrestrial bacteria hitched a ride? For example, there's been concerns about NASA's Curiosity rover currently exploring Gale Crater. After the rover was launched to Mars before landing in August 2012, the rover's wheel tread and drill bits were singled out as possible safe havens for microbes. Although some of the flows of liquid water have been discovered in the vicinity of Curiosity, astrobiologists have warned NASA that the rover may be contaminated enough to deposit some earthy microbes on these slopes, and they could potentially set up home on Mars, using this toxic water as fuel. Of course, it's a long shot, but when searching for arguably the most important discovery for humankind, it would be great to know that the aliens we discover are indeed extraterrestrial and not microbes of terrestrial origin. Currently, scientists are hard at work identifying which bacteria might be able to survive the cold, highly radioactive conditions of space and be able to colonize the Red Planet. One particularly tough bacteria is known to hang out in NASA's clean rooms after decontamination. So astrobiologists are sending samples of this bacteria on a high-altitude balloon to see if they die in the near-vacuum environment of the upper atmosphere. The concern about contamination could, however, be moot. There's already the idea that Mars may already be contaminated with Earth microbes, as, over the evolution of the solar system, chunks of Earth rock filled with bacteria have been blasted from the surface via asteroid impacts and floated over to Mars, landing as meteorites. This hypothesis, known as panspermia, would spread life far and wide long before the first NASA missions to Mars. For more information about the discovery of liquid water on Mars and its implication for Mars bacteria, check out Trace's recent video.
In a paper published in Nature Geoscience, researchers announced that the Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter has found signs that water may flow intermittently on present-day Mars.
Make sure you check out that video. There's a link in the description if you're on your mobile device. And let us know in the comments below if you think planetary protection is a valid concern or not.